Randomized experiments are often considered the gold standard in research. But unfortunately, there are many problems that can happen with experiments in practice, and we've already talked about two of them. Survey non-response, sometimes you just can't gather data on people in the experiment, and non-compliance with treatment assignment. Sometimes you assign people to get treated, but they don't actually get treated. Now, unfortunately, there are even more problems that can happen in experiments, and that's what we're going to talk about next. So we'll begin with the problem of external validity and extrapolation. So often, we can only learn the effects of some aggregate program, like Medicaid. Okay? So when we do the Oregon healthcare experiment, what we learn is the effect of having Medicaid on whether you're depressed or not, or on your cholesterol. What we don't learn is the effect of all the individual components of Medicaid. Things like the copay, the deductible, the premiums, what kind of medical treatments it covers, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. So Medicaid is a very large and complicated program that has many different features. And if we find that there's some aggregate effect of Medicaid, so we do our Oregon healthcare experiment, we find that having Medicaid lowers depression. Why did it lower depression? Which feature of Medicaid really mattered for depression? Was it the fact that premiums were different, or that they had certain kind of coverage for mental health, for example? It's very hard to tell from the experimental data alone. So another way to put this is that we can't extrapolate from the results of our experiment to learn about policies that we don't see in the data. So if you were to propose a new healthcare plan that looked really different from Medicaid, okay, it still provided insurance to people, but not for the same, didn't cover the same treatments, had different pay structures, etc., it'd be very difficult or impossible to say anything about that given just the experimental data. Now, so what are we going to do? Well, there's a few things you can do. One is you can try to unpack these complicated programs by using a sequence of experiments. And in each experiment, you change the individual components of the program, like the premium structure, okay, or what's covered. And then by doing this many times throughout the data, you're going to get lots of variation along each one of these individual components. And you can learn something about the treatment effect of the components as opposed to the treatment effect of the aggregate program. Now, that's still going to be really difficult to do, especially with complicated programs like Medicaid. So often, that's just not possible to do in practice. So instead, what we'll usually do is use observational data to supplement the experimental data to try to learn about these individual components. And we'll talk about that in later modules. Another thing you could try to do is use your qualitative understanding of the context to try to interpret the results and determine what you think might generalize to other programs.